So praise the Lord. So today is very special moment for me. So today I'm going to share my testimony. So how God has changed my life. Before sharing my testimony, I want to pray. Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus, make me new. Wash me with your blood. But I don't know at all, but I come to you now. I need your help, Lord Jesus. Forgive me, save me, and be my Lord. I turn everything to you. I will follow you. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. So I am from Assam. My name is Kamal. So I am from Assam. It's a tribal called Missing Tribe. So from Assam, I'm from a small village, a small town called Dhemaji District. So I have my father, my mother, and my brothers. My father is a retired cultural officer. So I'm from middle class family. So I'm belongs from a background like Hindu family. So I'm grown and got up in a Hindu family. So the place where I grown and got up before I come to Christ, how God has changed my life. So I was nothing to something only by God's grace. Today I'm here. I'm able to sit. I'm able to get in the opportunity to share my testimony. Before I come to Christ, I don't know any Jesus Christ. In my hometown, no one knows about Jesus Christ. I think there is only one person Christian in our hometown. So I came from that person. So before coming to Christ, my life is I wasted my life a lot. I have wasted my life in doing lots of wrong things in my life, like smoking, drinking, lots of wrong things, cheating, gambling, partying. I have spoiled a lot. So lots of the young people today do. So I was that one of them. So it's very difficult for me. So my parents provide me everything. My schooling, my education, they provided everything. At some point, I didn't study well. I was, there's a place called in Guwahati. I studied in Bibura College. There I didn't study well. I got admission there. I wasted my life there. Still I continuing my bad habits, like smoking, drinking, and smoking ganja, eating hans, lots of tobacco. All those things I have done, which is not good for me. All those unnecessary things I have done. I used to do lots of flirting with girls also. So I was mingled with like some prostitute also. All those unnecessary things I have done in my life, which is not acceptable in this society. So I'm a sinner. So I have done many sins in my life. But God has changed my life. How God has changed my life? Once when I came to Chennai. In Chennai, I came back in 2015. So here, when I came here, so I find job here, started working here. I work very hard, but still I continue my bad habits, like smoking, drinking, partying. Always whenever I'm not able to save even a single money, it's because of my bad habits. So whatever I try to do, I always not able to save money. I used to earn a lot, but I'm not able to save any money. So back in 2018, I met my wife. She's from Manipur. So I started loving her. And 2019, I married her. Today, we have a small baby. So she's a Christian background. So I don't have any problem with Christian people. Because I believe that Christian also have God. Hindus have God. Muslim has a God. I respect every religion. I respect every God. I think that Jesus also one of them. So Jesus also one of them, I think like that. So I love my idol God so much. Every day I used to worship my idol God by putting flowers, by lighting the agarbattis. And I have lots of photos, Hanuman photo. I used to worship the God called Hanuman. I used to chant the Hanuman Chalisa every day. And there is a photo, sheep photo, Lakshmi photo, Durga photo, all those, and Krishna photo, Radha photo, every photo I used to have, Ram Lakshman photo, all those photos I have together in a book, in a place I used to worship. My wife also used to worship. He worshiped to Jesus. I worship to my God idol because I love my idol so much. But I don't have problems with worshiping to Jesus. My wife also always used to tell me, dear, why don't you come to Christ? Jesus is the only one. He's the only God. I say to my wife, I love my God so much. You worship to Jesus, I worship to my God. I used to say that. So I used to continue, like, she always used to say me, are you continue worshiping my idol God every day? She always used to say me, you worship Jesus the only God. Come to Christ. She used to. Someday I got angry one day. I told her, why are you Christian? Always try to convert to Hindu people. You worship God, I will worship my God. I told very hardly to her. The first, when I opened the book, I found Corinthians, 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verses 16 says, your body is your temple, and whoever destroyed God's temples, so God will destroy him. That day I realized that shocked me, how it can be our body can be temple. I'm finding God in the churches, in the temple. My body can be my God temple. I feel like that. When I look to me, when I realize my temple I have destroyed, I have made tattoos like this. I make tattoos in my body, I have destroyed. I smoke, I have drink, I have done prostitution, I have worked with many girls, I have slept with many girls, I have smoked. And I don't want to worship my God anymore. I don't find any peace. I share my story to my wife. On that very day, I take all my Hindu photos, Hindu murtis, I break everything. I tear all the mantra book and I pack in a polythene and throw in a dustbin. Because Jesus gave me peace on that day. But I come to Christ on that day. But I continue praying. But I still have confusion when I'm praying also, because I don't read the Bible. I don't know how to start with the Bible. I have very confusion. New Testament, Old Testament, Matthew chapter 5, verses 3, 2, 3, 4. What point? I don't understand. My wife also, she pray, but she don't know how to read the Bible. She don't know how to read them. That's the issue. But I want to know Jesus. Who is this Jesus? I want to experience more. So after a few weeks, the church started open. When the church started open, first day when I go to church, I find one pastor. His name is called Pastor Kasau. So I met him. So I give him my introduction. I share my testimony to him. So that day he shared some scriptures, Bible readings, and he sing some gospel songs. That the first time I experienced the church, I feel like so wonderful, so different. First time experience. I feel like that they're very wonderful. So I did the only 1 hour the program happens. But always eager to go to church, always. Every week when the church time comes, I always go with my family together, my wife, my baby, and myself. So like the day continues. Slowly I took the baptism also. Baptisms I took. So I continue reading Bible continuously. When I read the Bible, the first when I opened the book, I found there's a scripture called Luke chapter 6 verse 37. Just not, you'll not be just. You'll not be just. Condemn not, you'll not be condemned. Forgive, you'll be forgiven. Before judging to someone, judge yourself. Before condemning to someone, before putting blasphemy to someone, put blasphemy to yourself. Check yourself first. And forgive. Then only God will forgive us. Everyone is sinner, no one is perfect. So this memory verse taught me a lesson. So on that very night, I went to my home back home after receiving the prayer. So on that day, I went to my house. On the first time, I asked sorry to my wife. First time. I never say sorry to my wife. I never feel like telling sorry to her. I say sorry to my wife. Sorry. I confess every sin to my wife also, from my childhood till today. Whatever I have done. My wife happily agreed. That day, I feel very happy by asking sorry to my wife. Because I never say thanks to my wife. Because of my wife only, I'm safe. She only brought me to Christ. She always say in the name of Jesus, come to Jesus, come to Jesus. So when I come to Jesus, my wife has played a big role for me. That wife, I never give thanks. I started giving thanks to people. I started giving forgiving to people slowly, slowly. Before, I never used to forgive people. I started forgiving. I started loving to my enemies also, slowly, slowly. I started loving to God more. I started reading the Bible more, slowly, slowly. So me and my wife confess each other's sin. My wife also confesses every sin to me. I also confess. We both confess. We happily agree. From that day onwards, we never repeat our sin again. Because everyone is sinner. No one is perfect. So we should not judge our wife also. So that day, when I was praying at midnight at 12 o'clock, when I was praying, I feel like something touching me. My hand started vibrating a lot. I'm not able to control my hand. I feel like something is touching me. A different touch. First time I experience. So I feel like that day praying for my wife, because my wife is suffering from back pain since 1 year after her baby, after my baby deliveries. She's suffering from back pain for long, long times. So when I feel like praying for her. I lay my hand upon her. I pray in the name of Jesus to be healed. After praying this, my wife told me, I feel like something warm come to my body. My body is healed. This is the first miracle happened in my life. So God showed me first miracle. On that very night, I called the pastor at midnight. Pastor received the call. Pastor told me, I told the pastor, something I failed. My heart started vibrating. I'm not able to control this. Something different touches happening to me. Pastor told me, brother, you received the salvation and you received the Holy Spirit. I don't know what is Holy Spirit on that very moment also. What is salvation? Just pastor told me Holy Spirit and salvation. I don't know exactly. Slowly, slowly, I became more connected to God every day. The very first time I have shared the word of God, I have never shared before. Because Jesus is the only one who can change our life. Jesus is the only one who can heal us. Jesus is the only one who can give us peace, because He is the Prince of Peace. So this is my testimony. Thank you for listening to my testimony. God bless you all.